Bronxnet. Your voice, your views, your vision.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are those of the participants and do not reflect the views of Bronxnet or the program underwriters.
Next on the Bronx Journal, Hispanic Theater in the Bronx, a champion basketball team, and our reporters' roundtable to discuss the issues we are covering for the next edition of the Bronx Journal.
Watching the Bronx Journal, the BronxNet television edition of the multilingual community newspaper, published by the students and faculty of the Journalism, Communication, and Theater Department at Lehman College. In print and on television, the Bronx Journal covers the issues concerning the people of the Bronx. Do you want to know what's going on in the Bronx? Are you interested in Bronx politics, sports, and entertainment? Are you interested in Bronx personalities? Do you want to keep up with the latest business or cultural trends? In the Bronx Journal, we have the answers. Now here's your host, the Bronx Journal's editor-in-chief, Professor Miguel Perez.
New York is the capital of Latin entertainment. Nowhere else in the world can you find the variety of Hispanic music, food, art, theater. The city's Hispanic theaters often are mirrors that reflect the reality of life in the barrios. And in the Bronx, there's one particular Hispanic theater that has been digging out the roots of Hispanic culture and exposing them on stage to evoke very strong emotions and wonderful memories. It's called Pregones. In the next edition of the Bronx Journal, we will feature a story about Pregones and its many productions. And joining us today is the theater's director, Rosalba Rolón. It's a pleasure having you on the program.
Thank you for having me in the program, Miguel.
Thank you for being here. You and I go way back.
Many
years ago, I wrote a story for the New York Daily News about the beginnings of Pregones Theater.
I believe it was our first big story.
Oh, that I wrote?
Yes, okay. Our first big story, I think, in general. So thank you.
Okay, and at that time, you were just starting your theater. Mm-hmm. You were getting this space from a church, I remember correctly.
Yes.
This was in the late 1970s.
Yes, actually, this is 1981. Yes.
And this is when you started your theater.
We started in 1979, the theater,
okay.
Actually. But we began to work in the Bronx stores acquiring a space. But your first article, I believe, was when we were looking for that space. And then we got the space, and you broke the big story.
And
it was wonderful.
And tell the folks at home what Pregones Theater is all about.
Well, it is a theater, by now, 27 years old. And it was created as a touring company, as an ensemble touring company, to promote the Latino theater, mostly Puerto Rican-based stories at the time. Since then, of course, because we have grown so much, expanded so much, we incorporate many, many diverse voices in our theater, and we have artists from all over Latin America, and it is still a wonderful repertory of plays by established artists, new artists, original voices, you know. So it is musical theater. One of the things that we want to do and have been doing is developing an alternative, our own musical theater, not a copy of what's established out there, you know, but really using our own authentic music and voices to be able to create a very authentic musical voice in theater. And as of today, we have many, many repertories in place. And then after we opened our first space, we kept growing and moving. And finally, 2 years ago, we inaugurated our brand new theater in a building that we acquired on 149th and Walton Avenue, just a block off of Hostos College, actually. And right now, in addition to the work we do in the Bronx, and in our touring company continues to travel. That is a wonderful thing about what we've done is be able to sustain a touring company. We have visited more than 400 cities and 11 countries. We have a very, very large international program where we partner with companies from other parts of the world where they come to the Bronx, where we sort of share at home and abroad. So it's grown beautifully, actually.
Well, we're going to get into the details of some of that in a moment, but I think we have a video and we want to watch it of Pregones in action. So let's watch that.
Welcome, and I felt like I was home, being able to do theater at home. And secondly, I found that there was such a hunger for theater well done by Latino audiences to have their own stories told, and Pregones does just that.
Theater has always been the most collective art form.
It's a collaboration with roadside. The interesting thing about it was the commonality in the music and in a lot of the narrative.
But hopefully when people see the play, they will say to themselves, I never thought of this. This is different. This makes me see things in a different way. This helps me to ask questions of myself that I would never ask.